bigger than black and white. It's a problem with the whole way of life, can't change overnight. But we gotta start somewhere, might as well go ahead, start here. We done had a hell of a year, I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear.
What's up everyone, welcome back to another video. If you're new around here, my name is Nate. I'm a junior Olympic weightlifter, and this channel is all about my weightlifting journey, how far I can take things in the sport, and kind of my journey through life. Right off the bat, let's start the video we have planned, which is my big session of the week. Let's get this video started. We work up to 130 kilos in the snatch and 170 kilos in the clean and jerk. For the beginning portion of the video, I kind of want to explain what's going on. I know I haven't really made too much videos, and that's just because I don't want this YouTube thing to become like a job, and I do have fun making videos. I see my subscriber count creeping up towards 1,000, and it's been a big goal of mine to get to 1,000, and I'm right there, and I knew that I could get there if I just kept cranking them out. However, this past month or two, I've kind of just have been putting my head down in training, been working really hard to qualify for Junior Pan Ams coming up, and my days were just kind of really routine. I mean, you got to go through these days if you want to progress in anything. It's just the same day in and day out routine. I'd wake up, I'd train, some days I'd have two sessions, come home, nap, sleep, recover, get ready for the next session, you know, and I feel like it was just, I didn't have time to make anything super cinematic or creative, and that's what I like making. If I did make videos, it would have just been set up my camera and chop up the edited clips after when I get home and throw them on YouTube. And if I'm being honest, that's really boring to me. I like making my videos creative and have a certain style to them. So that's kind of why I haven't been making videos, because if I were to do that, it would have kind of felt like a job to me. Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at right now. I'm kind of trying to figure out what I want to do. This channel is definitely not stopping. We're going to continue to hammer away. So enjoy, kind of, I don't know where I'm at lifting right now, but yeah, and just enjoy it for right now. You don't have to be the most genetically gifted, and everyone has something special in them, and it's up to them to kind of awaken that and go after what they want. I've been working 5 years, and I just now made my first junior world team. I'm not stopping there. So basically, if you put the work in, it'll come. You don't have to be the most genetically gifted, and everyone has something special in them, and it's up to them to kind of awaken that and go after what they want. I've been working 5 years, and I just now made my first junior world team. I'm not stopping there. So basically, if you put the work in, it'll come. So as you guys can see, on my snatches, 130 was really nice. Felt good, I felt confident, and 130 had been kind of a mental battle for me. I've hidden it a lot in the past, but for some reason, getting back in shape this cycle, it was kind of a mental barrier. And on my program, I had filled up all my snatch attempts. So mentally, I kind of moved on, which is something I need to learn. I mentally moved on, so therefore when I put 135 on, I wasn't as intense and I wasn't as patient with it. I kind of just rushed it, trying to get under it. And that's something I really need to work on, is staying mentally sharp and ready to take weights no matter what. So I kind of, that was my first mistake. And then the clean and jerks, I nailed 170. Again, I made the mistake of moving on. I thought it was my last one, and that's all I was gonna do, and I was done for the day. So my adrenaline, especially after clean and jerks, just totally dropped. I put 175 on the bar, and I could not psych myself up. I could not get myself into the right state to do it. I pulled it, and I didn't want to get under it because I didn't want to hurt myself. And I know I sound contradicting myself right now, and Olympic weightlifters, when you have to lift something, but I was just really checked out. And as you guys can see, Coach, in the last clip, Coach was talking to me about this, and it's, you can't be satisfied. You can be excited about your achievements, but you cannot be satisfied, especially when it comes to a competition. Say that was my second attempt, and I need to take a third attempt to earn a total I needed to qualify for something or win a medal. You can't ever be satisfied, and you have to stay mentally sharp and ready until you're finished. And that is something I failed to do right there, and it showed. So again, I've been doing this for 5 years. No way I am professional, but in no way I'm a beginner. I'm kind of trying to turn myself into a professional weightlifter right now. It comes with a lot of believing in yourself, hard work, and just going out there and competing. No matter how long you've been doing this, there's so much to learn always. There's always things to learn. So that is a big lesson I learned from this session, and will continue to learn from that and try to apply it for my future sessions and heavy days. That's it for this video. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys all for your support. Hit that sub button. Let's get to 1,000 subscribers, and I will see you guys next time. Thank you guys. They know that we can strum anywhere that's bigger than black and white. It's a problem with the whole way of life. It can't change overnight, but we gotta start somewhere. Might as well go ahead, start here. We done had a hell of a year. I'ma make it count why I'm here. God is the only man I fear. Fuck it, I'm going on the front line. He gon' bust your ass if you come past that.